the question is actually for someone that is starting on this path and starting on this road that is a lifelong journey of self-discovery, you know, of who you are and the ups and downs of it, how do you remain motivated and inspired?
That's another one of the things where we all are motivated by different things. And we all have different things that inspire us, you know. So I always feel like, go back to the source of the thing that made you want to do it. If it's listening to music, listen to music. If it's you wanted to make your mama laugh, if your mother is still with us, make your mama laugh. If it's that you wanted people to stop picking on you, make them stop picking on you.
If you were to be talking to someone who feels like they started behind or feels like they don't have the skills that they need, how would you respond to that concern?
It's a constant learning experience. At no point in time will you ever feel like you've got all the answers or you're finally catching up. I have to tell you, even the day after I won the Pulitzer Prize, I still felt like I had so much to learn. People were like, you've arrived. I'm like, are you kidding? I now know how little I know. So the trick, Si, is just to constantly be exploring. Let yourself go ahead and learn, and don't be afraid to fail. We all make mistakes in our writing, and I've done this more than you can imagine. I think I've withdrawn like 30 different pieces that I feel like they just weren't good, but they were all stepping stones along the way of learning and growing as an artist. And for your entire life, this is the good news, you won't know everything, but that keeps it refreshing and it keeps it an interesting journey.
When you practice, how do you stay focused and get good quality work done?
We go to our instrument and it's a very physical activity. So you're immediately, as soon as you start playing, you're hit with something that you didn't like, or you're hit with something that you haven't done right, or there's all kinds of things that come towards you. And actually, one of the best things that you can do is determine before you pick up your instrument, what are the four or five things that I know are my priorities and I'm struggling with at the moment? And you can write them out. Never ever practice for longer than you're concentrating. So if you feel like you're actually, your mind is going everywhere and you're just not concentrating, it's much better to stop, go and do something else and come back.
As a professional pianist, do you still get nervous before a performance?
Eventually, as you perform in public, you begin to see the things that you do, that you tend to do when you perform nervous, and you try to find solutions. One of the things that my great teacher in Bloomington, who was my idol in many ways, George Shebok, who was a Hungarian guru of the piano, he talked a lot about breathing. And not just, you know, he talked about two things. There was the breathing that we all know of the lungs, and there was also the breathing of the arm and the wrist and the back, you know, and the sense of the release in the physical mechanism, yeah? And he connected those two things, and there were also the ways that music breathes, right? That the phrases breathe, you know, you have, I don't know. Connecting the breath of the music with the breath of the body and the breath and your own breath.
A lot of people want to know, do you practice your expressions?
Just because it's a performance doesn't mean like everything's practice. You know, I definitely, like, it's just how I am, you know, how the music is in that moment. If it's like, rah, then you got to get the rah. And then if it's like, ooh, then you got to go ooh, with like that, you know?
What is it like every time you step on the stage with, you know, the greatest orchestra on the planet, the Berlin Philharmonic?
I realize it's so much easier to play in a good orchestra. Mm-hmm. The better your colleagues are on, the more stable they keep in the intonation, the more they're able to shape phrasings in an understandable manner, the more they keep the pulse in a crescendo or in a diminuendo, and the more the collective power of the game